Hello students, in the previous video we had seen how to produce the output on the console. So console output was the topic. So we just printed the integer that using cout statement, right? Those who have not watched my previous video, please watch the same. The link is already shared, right? Next is about console input. As I told you earlier, in C++ the equivalent statement is cout, right? For printf equivalent statement for printf is cout. Similarly, for scanf the equivalent statement is cin. Okay, and left shift operator is used along with cout, and right shift operator is used with cin. You have to be careful. So they are called as cout operator and cin operator respectively, right? Now once again we'll see a programming example. Here this is to demonstrate how to read, how to perform the read operation. Earlier it was performing of write operation using cout statement, now performing of read operation using cin statement. Okay, once again the same header file you are supposed to use, iostream.h, hash include iostream.h. Since iostream is the header file or macro which stores the formatted IO functions, okay, formatted and unformatted both in case of C++, iostream.h which stores cin, cout statements and all. So in the main function, first step is variable declaration, as you are aware of, that is variable int x is declared. Then you are asking, see here, you will be asked to enter a number using cout. How to use the cout? See here, cout followed by left shift operator, then inside the double quotes write the string. If it is a string, use double quotes. Anyhow, you are using double quotes, right, in case of writing a string in C and all. The same way, okay, enter a number is the text message or string, followed by you are going to read the number. Earlier in C we have considered it as what, scanf, but now we are not considering, now we are considering only cin statement, cin followed by right shift operator, that is cin operator followed by name of the variable. No need to mention that percentage d and all like placeholders like in C. Okay, on C we are supposed to mention those things, but in C++ those things are not required. Directly it reads the value from the location x. Next is display. So you entered, what is entered by you will be displayed, the value of x will be displayed. Okay, if you see the output you will understand. So enter a number, 10 is the value you have entered, 10 followed by, say this is for your reference, enter is mentioned there. Okay, it will not be displayed on the console. You entered is the text message followed by what is the value you have entered, same thing will be displayed. That's it. C equivalent program, C equivalent statement for first cout statement is what? So equivalent statement here, printf, enter a number. Here what is the equivalent statement? Scanf percentage d, in case of C these things you have to put to, supposed to mention, followed by ampersand x. See here, this is the equivalent statement. Now in case of cin, slightly the things are simplified, no need of writing placeholders and all, directly mention cin followed by right shift operator, that is cin operator followed by name of the variable. Okay, here is another example. So here two variables are declared, int x and y, and you will be asked to enter two numbers. Hope this is clearly visible. See here, you can read two numbers at a time using single cin statement. It is very easy to understand. Cin followed by use cin operator. First value you mention, I mean first variable, followed by same right shift operator use. Second value you mention, put a semicolon. That's it. Okay, please go through the comment line, cascading the extraction operator. Similarly, for cout, you can print multiple values in the same cout statement, cout followed by cout operator, then string, if you are writing, means use double quotes. So you have entered something you mentioned, followed by use the same cout operator, which value you want to display, mention that variable name. Okay, use the same operator once again. If you want to display some string, see, we want to write and here, use it, write it, followed by second variable, followed by semicolon. Right? Please observe these two statements. You will understand how we can cascade the multiple variables inside a single scene and cout statement. Very easy program. Here the output is enter two numbers. Say two numbers are entered by you. You entered, say 10 followed by and is there as a string. In place of y, you will be receiving value 20. Okay, please go through the program. Please note it down. If you have any doubt, please ask. Thanks for watching. See you in my next video.